This video will show you how to prepare and load the sample tube for the chemisorption analysis on the Micromeritics Autochem 2 Automated Catalyst Characterization System. Remember to always consult your operator's manual for more detailed information. The tools and materials you will need for the sample preparation are an Autochem sample tube, quartz wool, a weighing dish, a sample tube weighing support, a balance, pipe cleaners, a glass funnel, a glass rod, a 3/8 inch wrench, a pair of heat-resistant gloves, sample tube retaining nuts and ferrules, and CalRes O-rings size 9 and 13. The Autochem sample tube is made of fused quartz with the capability to endure the maximum furnace temperature of 1100 degrees Celsius. It is composed of the larger inlet compartment in which the sample is loaded and the outlet where gas flows through after it passes over the sample bed. Before loading the sample, place a pinch of quartz wool at the bottom of the sample tube with the provided glass rod. Be careful not to compact it too much to prevent a pressure buildup during analysis. Place the sample tube weighing support on the balance and tear. Weigh the sample tube with quartz wool for the empty tube mass and record. Load the sample of your choice on top of the quartz wool. The sample tube can handle powders and pellets up to 9 millimeters in diameter. A glass funnel is recommended for powdered samples to help minimize sample loss. Use a pipe cleaner to clean the walls of the sample tube. Make sure the sample bed is within the hot zone, which extends to about 2.5 centimeters from the bottom of the tube. Place the sample tube weighing support on the balance and tear. Weigh the sample tube with the sample and record. Now the sample tube is ready to be attached to the instrument. Carefully slide the sample retaining nuts and ferrules over the inlet and outlet of the sample tube. Place CalRes O-ring size 13 on the tip of the inlet and size 9 on the outlet. Check if the O-rings are clean and free of debris or cracks to ensure a good seal. Replace them if there are any defects found. Slide the sample tube into the sample port until it comes to a stop. The thermocouple should sit inside of the inlet of the tube. Screw both of the sample retaining nuts until they are finger tight. To ensure an accurate result, the thermocouple should be placed right above the sample bed without touching the sample, especially for temperature programmed analyses. To set the thermocouple, we need to access the analysis valve heat zone. It is also called the sample valve heat zone. which is located on the top panel of the instrument. In the Microactive software, go to Unit, Enable Manual Control, and right-click on the sample valve heat zone to set the temperature to 20 degrees Celsius. Be sure to wear a pair of heat-resistant gloves to protect your hands. The thermocouple and the components nearby may be hot. Pull the handle up to open the hinge top panel. Open the front panel for better access. Remove the sample valve cover, which is the second cover from the left. The sample valve cover is held in place by two knobs. Remove the cover by pulling the knobs outward until the cover is released. Pull the cover up and out. Remove the insulation. Unscrew the peak ferrule located on the lower right with a 3/8 inch wrench. Set the position of the thermocouple to 2 to 3 millimeters above the sample bed. Ensure both the sample and the thermocouple are placed within the heated zone, which is the black area on the furnace. Once set, tighten the peak ferrule. Place the insulation in its original position. Reinstall the sample valve cover and close the top panel. Finally, close and lock the furnace. Now the sample is ready for analysis. And that completes this demonstration on how to prepare a sample on the Micromeritics Autochem 2 Automated Catalyst Characterization System. For more information, visit micromeritics.com/learn.